Hey, everybody, it's me, Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie. On this episode of CD Junkie, I'm going to be talking about a great artist by the name of Rupert Hine. Now, a lot of people know Rupert because he's a very famous producer. I mean, he's produced Rush, Stevie Nicks, Howard Jones, The Fixx, Krista Berg, Thompson Twins, Underworld, Kevin Ayers, Tina Turner, Saga, just tons of records. In fact, you probably own something in your collection produced by Rupert Hine. Now, all that work is great, but I'm going to be talking about Rupert Hine, the artist. And I always like to start these videos off by telling you how I got into the group, and that was because of the Fixx. I went out and I bought their 1982 debut album, Shuttered Room, and I saw that it was produced by Rupert Hine. Now, the name was not that familiar to me at the time, but in my travels going up through the record bins in L.A., I came across an album called Immunity by Rupert Hine, so I immediately bought it, and I fell in love with it, and I've been a fan ever since. I went a little bit backwards, and then I continued forwards with his other projects as well. So let's get started here. Now, Rupert was part of a British duo, Rupert and David, with David McIver, and they put out a single in 1965, but his first actual solo album came out in 1971. It's called Pick Up a Bone. This came out on Deep Purple's Purple Records label. And, of course, you got Roger Glover on there. I think he actually produced it. Paul Buckmaster did the arranging. And it's a British folky, little quirky singer-songwriter stuff. I mean, it's not top 40 pop, but it's full of great, odd little melodies that make Pick Up a Bone a really good album. As I said, came out in 1971. And he followed that up with an album in 1973, also on Purple Records, called Unfinished Picture. And in fact, I think that the engineers on this album are Steve Nye and John Punter. They would go off and do production later, you know, in the new wave, post-punk era. A lot of great records there. But this was another great album full of, you know, whimsical sometimes, but also maybe even slight progressive acoustic pop. And plus, there's a bonus track on the CD of a song called Hamburgers. And anybody that has a song called Hamburgers, I'm all in. Now, in order to get through this video quickly, I'm not going to give you too much of his biography or his career. You know, I'm just going to stick with the music, but you may want to check out, you know, either Wikipedia or check out his website to get more information on all the great stuff he produced and worked on. But after those two solo albums, it was a couple years, he co-founded a band called Quantum Jump, and they released their debut album called Quantum Jump in 1976. Now, this is the first time that he was working with lyricist Jeanette Teresa Obstaj, or I'm sorry, I don't, it's O-B-S-T-O-J, wonderful lyricist, and pretty much he worked with her throughout the rest of his career, and there you go there. Lots of cool songs on this. There's a song on this album called Lone Ranger that came out as a single, I think in 76, but it wasn't a hit until 79. But I'll tell you about that in just a second. This is the expanded edition, like I showed you. Quantum Jump, featuring Rupert Hine, came out in 1976. In 1977, out comes the album Barracuda, which is their second album. Now, Quantum Jump is more of a fusion prog band, you know, more jazz fusion than prog, but it has both elements in it. Very quirky, and but a lot of really cool songs on it. This is an expanded edition, and it includes a bonus CD with bonus tracks. Now, in 1979, there was an album that was released by Quantum Jump called Mixing. Now, what they did is they took tracks off of both albums and remixed them for 1979. Then the song Lone Ranger became a hit. And talk about quirky. But that was it with Quantum Jump. They only had the two albums and then the remix album. So Rupert returned to his solo career, but this time he was focusing on keyboards. And when I say keyboards, I mean electronics. So he was getting into the whole synth movement, but more experimental. So his songs had great hooks. That's the thing about Rupert Hine. He was great with hooks. And Jeanette Teresa was providing these great lyrics. So you're getting those two things happening. But his arrangements were very inventive. You know, a lot of these keyboards and stuff were new in pop music in 81. And he's coming up with sounds that the other artists aren't. You know, he's putting his production skills and he's putting his creative skills into this music. And he came out with an album called Immunity in 1981. Wonderful album. Very moody. There's still that prog element where some of the songs have, you know, two or three different parts. and they're not really conventional pop songs. It's not like you can play them next to Soft Cell or Depeche Mode, but they are working sort of in the same electronic universe. But Rupert was far more creative in his arrangements and adding mood to the music, and it's really an awesome album. Marianne Faithfull is on the album, Phil Collins is on the album, and he was working with a guitar player named Phil Palmer, who would pretty much appear on almost everything, I think. But Immunity, fantastic. In 1982, out comes the album Waving Not Drowning, another fine album. In fact, I think side by side, I think I like this album better than Immunity. I think he was really comfortable working in this, you know, new electronic area, and like I said, he knew instantly how to add mood and atmosphere to these songs while also creating something new with these keyboard synthesizer sounds and still adding pop melodies to it. So Waving Not Drowning is a fine album indeed. But then his third album, I think, is the best of the three. And this is Wildest Wish to Fly. Really wonderful album. Came out in 1983. This has Robert Palmer on, I think, two tracks. And it's also got Jamie Westorm from the Fixx. And absolutely fantastic. I mean, it's emotional. It's a thing. He was able to wring emotion out of electronics. Not many bands can do that. And Rupert could do it easily. You know, he's off producing other people, but when he creates music himself, it sounds very unique and really, really wonderful. Now, the three albums I just talked about, Immunity, Waving Not Drowning, and Wildest Wish to Fly, they are all available in a box set called Surface Tension, which came out on Esoterics through Cherry Red. Now, for years, I've had these three albums individually. This actually contains everything that's on these plus two extra tracks. So, of course, I had to have it so I could have everything, you know, I could possibly get my hands on by Rupert Hine. And this just came out, and you're really going to want to give that a shot. Also, if you just want to sample a little bit of Rupert Hine, you might want to try the Unshy on the Skyline compilation, which features tracks off of all three of those albums remastered. Now, after The Wildest Wish to Fly, the next project he did was a soundtrack to the movie Better Off Dead. Wonderful, outrageous. Now, Rupert produced almost every song on the album, whether he sang it or not. And he also did some of the instrumental music that's featured on this. His best ballad, in my opinion, and probably one of the best ballads, if not the best ballad of the 80s, is on this album called Arrested by You. And it's really, really fantastic. There's also a duet called With One Look with Cy Kernan from the Fixx. And as you can see there's instrumentals. But I want you to pay attention. There is a song here called Come to Your Rescue, and it's credited to a band called Thinkman. And when I listened to it, when I bought the soundtrack, I go, that's Rupert Hine singing. Well, yeah, it ended up that Thinkman was a new band that Rupert Hine was part of. Well, that's what I thought. What it actually ended up being is Thinkman was Rupert Hine continuing his solo career, but under a band name. So all the album covers would have band members on it, but they weren't really on the album. They were just actors posing on the album cover. They were just basically Rupert Hine solo albums. But the Thinkman albums are bigger, you know, more production. You know, his sound changes along with technology. So when 86 rolled around, out comes the album The Formula, which is another fine collection of songs. Best Adventures was a single off of this, and it's fantastic. The title track is fantastic. You know, he has guest musicians on the albums, but it's essentially a Rupert Hine solo album under the Thinkman name. So in 1988, out comes Life is a Full-Time Occupation. This is the second Thinkman album. The sound just slightly changes as technology changes because he's adding new sounds, new textures into the music. And it's really a fine collection of songs, still quirky, and still he's got the picture of the band there when I think that he's actually the only real member on the album. In 1990 came the final Thinkman album called Hard Hat Zone. This album actually features one of my favorite Rupert Hine songs called Who's Winning the Human Race. Now, those three albums came out under the name Thinkman, but like I said, they're really just Rupert Hine solo albums. But if you want to hear stuff off of those, but can't find the CDs, maybe you should check out the Fighting Apathy with Shock, which is a collection under the Rupert Hine name, or Rupert Hine as Thinkman. This is sort of a best of those three albums, and it'll give you an idea of what those albums sound like. But that's it with Thinkman. The next project he put out is one I still don't quite 100% understand. It's a band called Spin 1-2, And the band features Paul Carrick on vocals, Rupert Hine on keyboard and vocals, Steve Ferrone on, or Ferroni it might be, on drums, Tony Levin on bass, and Phil Palmer on guitar. And we're talking, these guys are just ace players. This is just a superstar band. Every member of this band is top notch. I mean, Paul Carrick, one of our finest vocalists, that blue-eyed soul. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. But I still kind of don't get the album, to be perfectly honest. They're just doing old classic rock songs, but they're doing like, I mean, they're all playing them really well, but they're kind of like smoothed out a little bit. But with these players, there's no original material. It's things like Black Dog, Cashmere, Keep Me Hanging On, All Along the Watchtower, Reason to Believe, Feel Like Making Love, you know, things like this. And it's a fun album, definitely fun, but I was kind of hoping that, you know, when I heard about this band, that it was going to be original material. But you know what? With all these players, with Rupert in there, and, you know, especially Paul Carrick out in front on vocals, definitely something to check out. And finally, the last CD I'm going to talk about is Rupert's last solo album. It came out in 1994, called The Deep End. This is, in my opinion, his best. This is absolute. This is the culmination of everything that came before. You know, he's taken all the best elements from his past catalog, you know, the great hooks, the great lyrics, the mood, the atmosphere, and creating something entirely different, but entirely the same at the same time. This is him at his peak songwriting, performance is everything. There's a couple songs here that feature the group Underworld backing him up, and it's really incredible. This is my absolute favorite. Every song on this is worth your time. In fact, he does a song called Eyes Like Twins, which, believe it or not, Wilson Phillips did a version of that song. The Deep End is an amazing record by an amazing artist. And unfortunately, Rupert Hine passed away in June of 2020. And hopefully there's something in the vaults that can be released by him, because he's truly an amazing artist. Very influential, as I said, as a producer, as an artist. Incredible. And while some of the 80s albums sound a little dated, obviously because they were recorded in the 80s, you know, 40 years ago, they're still filled with wonder, because you don't know exactly what's going on. It's not straightforward pop. It's eccentric and eclectic and unique and creative. And that's really what we want to hear in an artist. But what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to play a medley. I've taken songs from every one of these albums, just little snippets. And it's really hard to do this for Rupert Hine, because sometimes his songs reveal their beauty over time. So in a 3 or 4 minute period, I could take 20 seconds out of the middle, but you're not going to really understand what came before and what came after. And you know, it's best to check him out. This is just a taste of what to expect. If you like what you hear here, definitely investigate. If you're not into what you hear here, definitely investigate, because maybe I'm removing only the pop elements and you might really like the experimental elements. So let's give this a listen, and I'll see you on the other side.
Tahoe, Matuku, I tend to do, call a Mickey door. feel the blood of a reptile run through the veins of a charm into my eyes, into my memory.
I never gave it a thought, I never thought I should think.
By you.
Anyway, that's it. I really appreciate you watching this video. It means a whole lot to me. Remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, to ring that bell for future notifications. And until the next time, remember me, I'm Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie.